This former military airbase in Prostejov, a small town in the southeast of the Czech Republic, is perhaps an unlikely venue to host a major sporting event. Yet this is where 25 teams from 17 different countries contested the FAI European Formation Skydiving Championships. But what is formation skydiving, and how exactly does it work as a competition?
Well, we got 35 seconds after we exit the plane, and we have to try to make as many randoms and blocks as we can, so all figures have names or numbers, and we try to do as many as we can within the 35 seconds. If you have the formation and you take what we call like a grip on the leg or on the arm, if everybody takes it in the right way, you get 1 point. If you miss a grip or you take a wrong grip, then you get no point. So that's a bit, simply said, the way out goes.
So in each round, the teams have only a very short amount of time to complete as many different formations as they can. It's all over in a matter of seconds, and the action takes place over 10,000 feet above the ground. So how do the officials keep score?
The cameramen go up with their team and they do the formations. They come down, download their video into a computer system. My judges take them from there. They sit in front of a computer screen and they judge it, they score it. Usually takes, once we receive a dive, maybe 10 minutes, and then it goes out. It's very important for that because most of the teams want to see their score before they go back up on their next round. We have a panel of five, and we have split decisions sometimes, but because there's five, there's never a tie. So two might bust, three won't bust, so it's majority rules. So if three say it's okay, then it's okay. And the other ones we don't worry about. If three say it's bad, then they don't get the point.
In a discipline that's all about split-second timing and synchronization, the only way to get it spot on is to practice over and over again, with or without the help of gravity. In each round, the teams are given a number of set formations they have to try to complete, and these formations differ from jump to jump. The exit from the plane is crucial. It has to be as slick as possible so that it can get straight into that first formation. During the course of the championships, those teams making it through to the final stages will complete 10 separate jumps. 1 point is awarded for every completed formation, and whoever scores the most points across all of the rounds will be crowned champions. The last European Championships were held in Russia back in 2007. The French team went into that competition as favourites, but had to settle for silver when their Belgian rivals beat them in a final round jump-off. But here in the Czech Republic, the French got off to a blistering start, scoring more points than anyone else in each of the first two rounds. Reigning European champions team Hayabusa were also on good form though, and a very strong performance in round two put the Belgians into a clear second place. Hot on their heels was Team Black Cat from Russia. Regular front runners in the major competitions, they're also pretty slick in the opening rounds, completing almost as many formations as the two favourites, and very much in contention for a medal. After two rounds then, it was Team Aerodyne Cypress Maubeuge from France who led the four-way open competition. 47 points scored, three more than Team Hayabusa. And it was even tighter behind with four teams covered by just 3 points. Obviously the most important piece of equipment for any skydiver is the parachute. After each jump it has to be carefully packed away in a very particular manner. Now you might think the competitors would insist on doing this themselves. Not true.
Of course they could do it, they all know how to pack. But it's a lot better use of their energy not to. Because it's tiring, it's a hard job, for sure. It takes a lot of energy. I'm especially cautious about everything, because everything matters. If I'm in a hurry, people are on a call, I can do it in 3 minutes. If you're not in a hurry, five.
In addition to the open category for mixed sex teams, there was also a separate women's four-way championship to be decided. Having lost their world championship title in their own backyard in 2008, the French were determined to retain their status as European champions. They clearly meant business. In each of the opening two rounds, they completed 19 formations inside the 35 seconds, three more than any of their closest rivals. Team Schickass from Germany were the best of the rest, scoring 16 points in round one and matching that exactly in round two. And just 1 point behind them, fellow Germans Incognito. So a 6 point lead for Aerocart Deep Blue Maubeuge from France. Chicas and Incognito locked in a battle for second, with British team Kaizen in fourth. Another British team, Body Flight Storm, are the reigning women's four-way world champions. But here, one of their members had switched to the eight-way competition.
The four-way and the eight-way are very similar in a lot of ways. Obviously, you have twice as many people in the formation, so they feel a lot bigger in the air. It's slower in a way because to reshuffle eight people rather than just four takes a little bit longer. But if you watch the really well-trained teams like for here, for instance, the French team, they've done a lot of training. They're very, very skilled. It looks just as fast as some of the four-way teams, so you can go just as fast. The other similarities are the exit is very important from the aircraft. We generally have one exit, so with the four-way you can exit all of the formations complete, so as soon as you come out of the door the formation is judged. With eight-way, however, because you have eight people, it's a little bit harder to do that for all of the formations. So we have one set exit which we then grip switch into a formation which gets scored. So for us the challenge there is to launch the exit as well as we can every time and then get a stable move on the hill, as we call it, to the first formation, so we get that first point scored as quickly as possible.
So let's catch up now with the progress of the eight-way championship. Well, once again, it was a French team that was making all the early headway. Aerodyne Cypress Maubeuge scoring 18 formations in round one and then 16 in round two to put themselves into a comfortable lead. German team EADS found themselves third after the opening round, but they fought back well on the second jump and moved up to second place overall. That was at the expense of Crystal Contour, another competitive Russian team on display here at the FAI European Formation Skydiving Championships. And behind them in fourth place, Team Fuchsian from Spain. Up ahead though, a 7 point lead for the French. Now for many of us, smiling is the last thing we'd be doing if we're about to jump out of an aeroplane. So why are these people so happy?
What's so attractive about skydiving? Just like any extreme sport, it's adrenaline. And I think that one of the things about skydiving that's especially appealing is anyone can jump out of a plane. Not anyone can snowboard well down a mountain. Not anyone can go surf a big wave. Not anyone can skateboard. But you can get in a plane and you can get out. Whether you're really good at it or not so good at it, you still have a lot of fun.
Every sport has its own risks, and with this is the same, but in general you can say that it's really safe. So yeah, of course there's a little bit it's not a danger, but you know, there's something you have to keep your mind with it, but if you do that, it's completely safe.
The thoughts of Roy Jansen, a world champion with Team Hayabusa. But could the Belgians now add a European four-way open title to their CV? Well, it wasn't until round 9 that they finally outscored the French 25 points to 22, and they continued their late charge with an excellent score of 31 on their last jump of the competition. So that put at least some pressure on the French going into the 10th round. As it was, they held their nerve, matched the Belgians' final round effort, and took a deserved victory at the FAI European Championships. Meanwhile, the battle for third went right down to the wire, but despite losing some points in the final round, Team Synapse from Italy held on to narrowly beat both Russian teams to the bronze medal. The final results then, Aerodyne Cypress Maubeuge from France taking the title with 240 points, 11 clear of the world champions. After a week of jumping, only 5 points separated the next four teams, Synapse just doing enough to finish third.
I feel very proud about this performance. This team did the second place 2 years ago at the World Cup in Russia, and it was the goal of the team for this year to win, so I feel much better now.
Meanwhile, the French women's team were even more dominant in their four-way competition, winning all 10 rounds, and in this final round alone, they scored 6 more formations than anybody else. So it was all about the battle for the silver medal between the two German teams. They'd been virtually inseparable throughout the week, and going into the last jump, Chicas held a slender 3-point advantage. That left Team Incognito with a target of 25 points from their final effort. They gave it their all, but ultimately fell just short. 22 points enough to narrow the gap, but not enough to move ahead. So in the end, there was just 2 points in it, Chicas holding on to second from Incognito. British team Kaizen took a distant fourth place, but with a massive 41-point advantage, it was France who retained their European crown.
Happy with the competition. We are now the winner of the European Championship, so it's really cool for us, and we are very happy with this result.
And finally, in the eight-way formation, Team Aerodyne Cypress Maubeuge secured a hat-trick for France as they too dominated their discipline, winning all but one of the 10 rounds. Indeed, the top four positions remained unchanged throughout the week, with Team EADS from Germany taking silver, Crystal Contour from Russia with the bronze, and Team Fuchsian from Spain finishing just behind in fourth. All in all then, a hugely impressive championships for the French, 3 titles on offer, and they won them all. France remain the dominant force in European formation skydiving.
We are very happy because it's the first year with this team, and we won our first competition. So we are very happy with that because we didn't jump a lot this year because of the crisis and because it's a new team. We were a little bit worried before the competition, but after the jumps we were very happy. First because we won and we did some good jumps. So we need to continue like that for the World Championship next year.
Happy faces all round then from everybody that took part in the FAI European Skydiving Championships. In its 9th edition, this remains a sporting contest of the highest level, a mixture of bravery, coordination and teamwork. But most important of all, the competitors enjoyed every single minute of it.